welcome back to Tried, Tested, and True Instant Pot Cooking, where I share with you Instant Pot inspiration and ways to feel confident with your Instant Pot. I'm Lisa Childs, and today I'm going to be answering 11 of the most frequently asked questions I get. So the first question I always get is, isn't an Instant Pot the same thing as a crock pot? The answer is no. Actually, a crock pot or slow cooker is kind of the opposite of an Instant Pot pressure cooker. So a slow cooker cooks at a low temperature for an extended amount of time, usually hours, and a pressure cooker cooks at a very high temperature for a really short amount of time. So fast and slow cooking, it's very different. Along the same lines, I always see this question, can I get rid of my crock pot? Personally, my answer to this question is no. I think the Instant Pot does an amazing job at cooking most things really fast, and it can replace the slow cooker or crock pot, but I also think that there are just a couple things that the slow cooker or crock pot can do better than the Instant Pot. The Instant Pot does have a slow cook button on it, but I don't think it works quite as well as the slow cooker, and so I recommend keeping your slow cooker. Now, I used to have two crock pots, so I did get rid of one, and now I have like a million Instant Pots, but I think that there are just some things that the Instant Pot does better and that the slow cooker does better. So you can watch my 5 things I never make in my Instant Pot video right here, and let's see if we agree or disagree on those things. Next question, how does an Instant Pot even work? A pressure cooker works by boiling some sort of liquid, which creates steam, and then it gets locked inside of this device, this appliance, and then all that energy and all that heat has nowhere to go, so it squeezes it into the food. That super high temperature just helps cook things super quick, and that's why it's called an Instant Pot. This next question I see on the Instant Pot community page on Facebook, it's, my food came out undercooked, what did I do wrong? The answer is probably nothing. I mean, like in all cooking, there's always going to be variability in the temperature, the size, the thickness of your ingredients, the coldness of your ingredients, the freshness of your ingredients. And so not everything is always going to cook the exact same time based on a recipe. That being said, if something is undercooked, all you need to do is just cook it a little longer. So make sure that there's enough liquid in there, put the lid back on your Instant Pot, turn the knob to sealing, and then cook for just a couple more minutes and see if it's fully cooked after that. The next question is, do I have to add water? Yes, because the Instant Pot uses pressure created by steam, it needs some sort of thin liquid to first boil to make that steam to make the pressure in the Instant Pot. You can use water, broth, juice, soda, or any type of thin cooking liquid, as long as it's not dairy or like a tomato-based product, something that's going to burn really easily, don't use that. But you do have to use water or some sort of thin liquid every single time you cook. The next question is, can I make blank in my Instant Pot? The simple answer to this question is, if it's something that usually sits on the stove and cooks, boils, or steams for an extended amount of time, then yes, it probably can be made in the Instant Pot. That being said, there are some things you can make in the Instant Pot, but I don't necessarily think that you need to or should. Some things aren't necessarily a time savings. It almost is always about convenience because it's hands off. You can just put it in the Instant Pot and it will be done. You don't have to worry about babysitting something on the stove. Next, I get a lot of this question, what's the first thing I should make in the Instant Pot? Well, I actually recommend doing something really easy, simple, inexpensive, just in case it doesn't turn out, because you don't want to be devastated if you've spent all this time and money making a really nice meal and it just doesn't live up to your expectations. I recommend doing hard-boiled eggs or mashed potatoes just because they're easy, simple, inexpensive to make, and it's a good way to just get started using your Instant Pot. I get this question a lot of times in my comment section on my website, on my Instagram, and on YouTube. It's, how do I double a recipe? This is a really good question, and the answer is to just double everything in the recipe except the time. Now, I know that seems kind of weird, but you don't need to cook it for double the amount of time. Just cook it for the same amount, unless there's a lot of big chunks of meat or anything that's really clumped together. Then I usually like to add a couple more minutes, but you just double everything but the time.
I should also mention that you don't need to double the water if you're only using a cup of water and putting something on top of the trivet.
Here's another one I see all the time. My meat is tough and dry. What did I do wrong? So you're either probably cooking it too little, too much, or you're not letting it naturally release the pressure after it's done pressure cooking. When you're cooking meat, try and find a reliable recipe to kind of do a base test on, and then you can decide if it needs a little bit more time, a little bit less time, and make sure you're doing a natural pressure release whenever you can. Next up is, how do I clean my Instant Pot? Okay, I have got an easy answer for you on this one because I have a full video on how to clean your Instant Pot from top to bottom on my YouTube. You can just click this link right here and that will take you straight to the video. I also have it in a printable PDF that you can get emailed to you for free on my website, trytestedandtrue.com. The last question is, what is the difference between an NPR and a QR, or a natural pressure release and a quick release? So I like to explain this using a soda bottle analogy. So a natural pressure release is like when you have a soda bottle and you shake it up and there's all that pressure built up in there, and then you just crack the lid open just a little bit and it's just releasing that pressure really slowly. There's no huge burst. It's just really slow and low. Very gentle. That is a natural pressure release, and that is what happens with your Instant Pot after something is done pressure cooking. It will automatically go to a natural pressure release. So the sealing knob will just crack just a tiny bit, and then it will allow the steam to escape, the pressure to escape very slowly. A quick release is like if you take that same soda bottle, shake it up, and there's all that built up pressure in there, and you just take that whole lid off and soda goes flying everywhere. That is what happens with your Instant Pot as well. When you flip the knob from sealing to venting, and then all the pressure releases in one quick go. All right, I hope that you enjoyed those 11 frequently asked questions. So what other questions do you have? Leave them in the comments below, and if I choose your question, I'll give you a shout out in my next video. Next, make sure you watch my 26 Instant Pot do's and don'ts video, and we'll see you next week. See ya.